I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Third in the 10th? Okay, yeah. Okay, what you're saying.
Okay, now speaking of the 10th, how's Sergey Lipinets doing? How's the hand?
Great.
He's happy, he's good?
Everybody's happy. You know.
Hey, everything happens for a reason. You know what I mean? So.
He's a great kid. He's a great person. He's a good fighter, he's undefeated, he's a champion, kickboxer. But Mikey's a great fighter too.
Don't worry about kickboxing.
I don't like to use the word great right now because it's too early in both their careers to call them great fighters. So use the word good. They're both good fighters.
One thing I can tell you, he's very respectful. He respects Mikey Garcia. He believes that Mikey Garcia deserves everything he's got. And me personally, I'm a little upset that somebody is looking over my guy. That's okay. Let him pick some other fighters. He's still going to have to fight Lipinets before that.
What do you guys think of Linares fighting Lomachenko? Looks like it's going to happen.
Isn't it too big?
Well, Linares is 135, Lomachenko is 130, so he's going to move up.
That's going to actually show what Lomachenko is all about. Because he's the first time in his career, he's going to have a guy that knows how to fight, knows how to move, big enough, I mean, real size guy. And we'll see what he's capable of.
Okay, what?
Lomachenko is going to show what he's got.
How about Lomachenko Pacquiao? Are you interested in that?
I'll be interested.
Manny Pacquiao, Lomachenko. But Lomachenko has to move up 2 weight classes, 3 weights.
I still watch it, you know? I mean, he just did.
I think that'd be a little too much weight.
But you still want to see what Lomachenko's all about.
But shit, if he has to go up that many weight classes, I don't even think you got nothing to prove if you got to go up there. I mean, that just don't make any sense.
At this point, it's all money, it's all business. That's what it is.
Exactly. I mean, if it's about the money and the business part, all right, cool. But to prove your greatness, if you got to go up that high.
Don't do what you say?
I mean, it doesn't make sense.
But look, Roy Jones Jr. and James Toney did it. Buddy, you trained James Toney.
Okay,
you went up from 160 to heavyweight.
James did because he was lazy.
There you go.
What about Roy? Roy's not.
Because
it was a challenge.
And then he proved himself, right?
He proved himself. But we're talking light heavyweight to heavyweight.
Right.
Now you're talking, what was Lomachenko?
130, a lightweight.
What was he before? He's always been 130?
No, 126, okay. 130.
It's different with smaller fighters.
The power doesn't carry it?
No, it's not even that. Just able to carry the weight. Okay, you figure he goes up and fight Pacquiao at 47. Let's just say.
Okay.
So that's 20 pounds heavier. So he went from 126 to 147. Now by fight night, he's probably over 150. Can he carry that for 12 rounds? It's a lot of weight. It's almost 30 pounds.
But look,
what I need is just to be there hanging with
the what I mean?
But when you look at Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather, when they fought at 47 or higher, they didn't never came in. They came in at 44, 43.
Okay, Mayweather went up to
52 for Canelo.
What do you weigh, 150?
McGregor?
What's his name?
Canelo? I'm good, how's it going, John? No, Canelo was 52. Canelo, it was a catch weight.
52. It's 5 pounds.
Yeah.
I mean, so that was nothing. But when you start talking, see, little fighters carry the weight much different than the bigger guys, man. You know, Roy was able to carry the 200. You know what I mean?
I'm good. How are you? Is that you on the shirt?
Yeah, that's
me. That's a cool shirt. You walk into the ring.
Hey, this is a saying. I'm looking at this thing, right?
Yeah.
It says, no matter how big your house is, how recent your car is, how big your bank account is, our graves will be the same size. Stay humble.
You know what reminds me, buddy? The joke of two people arguing over a piece of land, and the guy goes, it's my land, the other guy goes, my land, then the land tells, no, both of them, I own both of you.
That's what it is.
Yeah. That is very true, but
I got a clean joke for you. It's a
okay.
Clean joke.
Okay.
It's clean.
A 70-year-old widow puts an ad in the paper that she's looking for a husband. Right? She goes, I want a man that won't beat me, run around on me, and that's good in bed. So a month later, her doorbell rings. She goes to the door. There's a man sitting in a wheelchair. She goes, can I help you? He goes, I'm here to answer the ad. She goes, you have no arms. He goes, that means I can't beat you. She goes, you have no legs. He goes, that means I'll never run around on you. She said, are you good in bed? He said, I rang the doorbell, didn't I?
That's a good one. Did you get it?
Well, he was the one narrating the joke.
You know how many times I heard that joke already?
That's a clean joke, man.
You got it.
You can't laugh. Almost. You never laugh, Alex.
Oh, he laughs.
The laugh at you.
Of course I do.
Exactly. He won't laugh with you. You're right.
In the morning, buddy. I'm laughing.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best, Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing.